differential equations. Okay, so the question says solve d cube y by dx cube plus y is equals to 0. This is the question, and first step to put it in the operator form. So we have d cube, there is only the cubic term, nothing else, plus coefficient of y here is 1 into y is equals to 0, where here we have d is equal to d by dx. So d cube will be, capital D cube will be d cube by dx cube. Okay? So this is the operator form. Now auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is given by f of m is equals to 0. In this case, f of d is d cube plus 1. Therefore, f of m will be n cube plus 1 is equals to 0. And now we have to find the factors of this. So we can apply here the synthetic division. It's clearly visible that when I put m equal to minus 1, we get a 0. Minus 1 is one of the roots. Therefore, what I will do? First, consider the coefficients. M cube, coefficient of m cube. Carefully look at this. So, observe this one. Coefficient of m cube is 1. But we are missing out with m square. That means I am rearranging this particular equation in this format. M cube plus 0 m square plus 0 m plus 1 is equals to 0. All the missing terms should be taken with a 0 coefficient. That is the major thing. So here we can take a 0 here for the m square, and then a 0 for m, and then we have a constant that is equals to 1. Hope this one everyone understood. I repeat this part. The equation is only m cube plus 1, but when I give the hierarchy, when you consider all the terms in the descending orders of the powers of m, then we have m cube, m square, m and constant, right? So, but the missing terms, I can't just keep them here. I have to give the coefficient for the missing terms as zeros. So that's how we got this. Alright, now minus 1 is satisfied by the equation. Okay, so we can consider minus 1. Now starting with 0, you need to add here 1 plus 0 is 1. Take the product. This one has to be multiplied. So 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Write it here. Again add 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Again consider the product. So minus 1 into minus 1 is 1. Again add it. Again take the product. So 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Adding these two, we get a 0. So 0 is a remainder. That's it is a accepted. I mean, minus 1 is one of the roots of this equation. So, consider this part, and now we are going to construct the quadratic form. Therefore, we have m cube plus 1 equal to 0 can be written as m plus 1 is one of the factors in 2. Consider these coefficients, and hence we get this is m square, m and the constant term. So, 1 m square minus 1 m plus 1 is equals to 0. Now, apply splitting the middle term here. So, m square, so applying the splitting the middle term, we can't split it here. So, instead we can use the quadratic formula. So, the quadratic formula says, here let me solve this part. M square minus m plus 1 equal to 0. Coefficients are a is 1, b is minus 1 and c is 1. So, applying the formula, m is equals to minus b plus minus under root of b square minus 4ac by whole divided by 2a. Okay, so substituting the values of a, b and c here, we have minus of minus 1 is plus 1, plus minus under root of b square is 1 minus 4ac. You get complex roots here, 2a is 2, so 1 plus minus under root of 1 minus 4 is minus 3 divided by 2. We can write this as 1 plus minus root 3i whole divided by 2. We can split it into two parts. 1 by 2 plus minus root 3 by 2i. This is the real part and this is the imaginary part. So, these are the roots. Now, what are the roots? Therefore, m is equals to minus 1 is one of the roots. And we have another two roots given by the pair of complex value. Okay, so now let us write the final solution of this, which is given by the complementary function y is equal to. So we have this is real root. So c1 e to the power coefficient of x is this value, that is minus 1x, which can be written as minus x plus. And we have a pair of complex roots here, so we need to consider e raised to real power, that is 1 by 2 into x, which is x by 2 into, after c1, we take the next constant c2. C2 cos, imaginary part goes for the coefficient of x in the angle of sine and cos. So c2 cos root 3x by 2 plus c3 sine root 3x by 2. So this is how you get the solution for the given differential equation, homogeneous linear differential equation. Understood? So this part, because of the roots, we get like this. You got it? So this is how you solve. Let us see one more problem. Okay students, let us see another problem. The question says 4d power 4 minus 8d cube minus 7d square plus 11d plus 6 into y equal to 0. The question is already in operator form. So the first step, you don't have to again do it. Directly you can go to the auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is f of m equal to 0. This entire thing is f of d. Wherever d is there, we are going to replace d by this m. So we will get 4m raised to 4 minus 8m cube minus 7m square plus 11m plus 6 equal to 0. So this is the polynomial equation, is a biquadratic equation. So we need to solve it, and how many roots you are going to get? It's a fourth degree equation, so you are going to get 4 roots for m. That means m will take up 4 values. So by trial and error method, we can see m equal to 1 is satisfied here. So it is clearly visible that m is 1 as the one of the roots of this biquadratic equation. Applying the synthetic division here, we get first consider all the coefficients. You don't have to give any zeros because all the m powers are there in this particular equation. So m 4, 3, 2, 1 and constant. Hence consider only the coefficients 4, minus 8, minus 7, 11 and positive 6. Just now we saw m is minus 1 is one of the roots. Therefore, considering the synthetic division with m equal to minus 1, what do we get? So starting with 0, 4 plus 0 is 4. Take the product, we get minus 4. So again, minus 8 minus 4 adds up to give you minus 12. Consider the product, negative 1, negative 12 is going to give you positive 12. So again, add up. So we are going to get 12 minus 7 is 5. 5 minus 1 is again 5 into minus 1 is again minus 5. So the sum here, this is going to be again every time sum only. Okay, so it's going to be 6. 6 into minus 1, the product is minus 6, which is going to add up to give you 0 as the remainder. Understood? So this is the equation which has got reduced to cubic form now. So we have to again apply trial and error method. So applying trial and error method, we get when m is 1, it is not satisfied. Why? Because you get only one negative value, minus 12, and all these add up to give you more than minus positive 12. So m is 1 is not a factor. Similarly, m is minus 1 is also not a factor. But when m equal to 2, we get, substituting here, 2 cube into 4 is 8 4 is 32 minus 2 square into 12, 12 4 is 20, 12 4 is 48 plus 5 2 is 10 plus 6, which is going to add up to give you 0. Hence we get 0 equal to 0. Therefore, m is 2 is one of the roots. So considering the synthetic division with m with the value 2, the root 2 here. So starting with 0, 4 plus 0 is 4. Take the product, 4 2 is 8. Again add up, minus 12 plus 8 is minus 4. So consider the product. Minus 4 into 2 is minus 8. So again add up to give you minus 3. So minus 3 into 2 is minus 6, which is going to give you 0 as the remainder. Hence, what are the roots here? 1, minus 1 and 2 already are the roots. But we again get a quadratic equation here, which is going to be 4m square minus 4m minus 3 equal to 0. So solve the quadratic equation by applying, splitting the middle term, because we are getting the factors properly in this case. So you don't have to apply quadratic formula. Directly splitting the middle term will be easier. So solving this, we get m is 3 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. Hence, all the four roots of m are minus 1, 2, 3 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. List them all here. Construct the complementary function, which is nothing but the solution of this given homogeneous differential equation. So, what is that? C1 into e raised to first value goes. All these are unique roots. So, minus 1 into x, which is minus x. C2 e power 2x plus C3 e to the power 3 by 2 into x. And then C4 e raised to minus 1 by 2 into x. So, this is the complementary function, are the solution for the given differential equation. Understood? Also, let us see one more problem where we can find the values of the complementary find the values of the constants here. Constants of integration, all these are basically C1, C2, C3 and C4. So, we will see a particular case that is called a particular solution. This is a general solution of this particular given differential equation. But when we get appropriate values for constants by using the given conditions, then we get something called a particular solution. So let us see quickly one more problem based on the particular solution. Y equal to 2. So we have some values and also dy by dx and d square by dx square are equal. Okay. So y equal to 2 and dy by dx is equal to d square by dx square. When are these two conditions applicable? When the independent variable x equal to 0. So this is the condition. So, we use these conditions to find the values of C, but the initial part is the same. That means, from the given equation, you construct the, you frame the same equation in terms of the operator form. So, we get d square plus 4d plus 5 into y is equal to 0. Next, the auxiliary equation. So, what is the auxiliary equation? F of m equals to 0. F of m equals to 0, it gives us m square plus 2m plus 5 is equals to 0. So, this is the auxiliary equation and you can't get factors for 5 that add up to give you 2 at all. So, no splitting the middle term will work out. Applying the quadratic formula, m equal to minus b plus minus under root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. And what are ABC values here? A is 1, B is 2 and C is 5. Substituting the values, minus 1 plus minus under root of 1 square is 1 minus 4AC. So, minus 2, B is 2 here. Sorry. So, it's going to be 4. 2 square is 4 minus 4A into C. C is 5 whole divided by 2A. That is equals to minus b is minus 2 plus minus under root of 4 minus 5 fours is 20 by minus 2 plus minus, this is under root of minus 16 by 2. that is equals to minus 2 plus minus root 16 I, because under root of minus 1 is I by 2. Simplifying ahead, minus 2 plus minus root 16 is 4, 4 I by 2. Take out 2 common, we get minus 1 plus minus 2 I divided by 2. That gets cut, minus 1 plus minus 2 I is the roots for the given differential equations. So what is our complementary function? Y is equal to directly only the quadratic complementary functions only. Sorry, complex roots only. So we can just directly take e raised to real value, that is minus 1. So minus 1x into c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. And we got the 2 from the imaginary part of the complex roots. Got it? So this is going to be our complementary function or the general solution of the given differential equation. Now we need to find what is the derivative dy by dx and also v square y by dx square, so that we can equate them, substitute to find the given condition, and hence find the values of these two constants c1 and c2. We have only two constants here and we have to find both of them. So finding the first derivative here, we got to apply here product rule. So first function e raised to minus x as it is, differentiating the second function entirely, considering c1 and c2 as constants. C1 as it is, derivative of cos 2x is minus 2 sin 2x plus c2 as it is, sin, derivative of sin 2x is 2 cos 2x plus. Okay, this entire thing is as it is. And then if you differentiate e raised to minus x, what is that you are going to get? Minus e raised to x. So I will directly write here minus e raised to minus x, and this part is the same, c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. This is entirely our y. So simplifying further, take out 2 common, 2 e raised to minus x into minus c1 sin 2x, okay, plus 2c2, sorry, 2 is taken out, so c2 cos 2x minus z entire thing is our y. What is this entire thing? It's going to be y, okay. So, what do we get here? So, we get entire thing is my y dash, which is equal to y double dash. Y double dash is 2e raised to minus x minus 2c1 cos 2x minus 2c2 sin 2x minus y dash. See, whatever y dash here I get, I can write it same thing. Okay? So, instead, we can still more write it in the simplest way. Let me put it in the most simplest form possible. This entire thing is y dash I write as it is equal to 2e raised to minus x minus 2c1 cos 2x. You can take out a minus 2 common here. So it becomes minus 2 into 2e raised to minus x. So c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x minus y dash. Y dash can be taken this side. This implies y dash is 2y dash is equal to minus 4e raised to minus x. C1 cos 2x plus C2 sin 2x. Now substituting x is 0. What we need to substitute here? So x is 0. This is going to give us one condition. Later we can consider y is 2. Both we can consider. Alright? So which is going to give you two equations. So substituting x is 0 in this particular equation, we get, so 2 times y dash, instead of y dash, I will write the entire part. Otherwise, we can consider the top part only. So whenever it is, that's better to take up the above part because it's easy to substitute. Again, else we have to put y value also. So, otherwise we can put y directly to your wish, whatever you want to do. Anyways, so substituting x is 0, sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1. So wherever we have sin terms, it's going to be vanished. Directly putting, taking only the cos terms. Sin 0 is 0, so this term gets vanished. Sin 0 is 0, so this term also gets vanished. So what are we going to get? E raised to 0, which is 1, is equal to 2 times of y dash. Is going to be. So I'm going to write 2 times of, instead of y dash, so 1, e raised to 0 is 1, this term is gone, 2c2 as it is, cos 0 is 1, so 2c2 as it is, cos 0 is 1, close the brackets, minus, again e raised to 0 is 1, so 1, again we have c1 cos 2x. This is going to be c1 into 1. Again, sin 0 is 0. So, this term gets vanished. This is equal to, we will consider the RHS here. This is the entire LHS there. And RHS is minus 4 times e power 0, which is 1. Again, here also, the sin term gets vanished because sin 0 is 0. And hence, this will become c1 cos 2x, which is c1 into 1. Okay, simplify this. What do you get? So you have 2 2's is 4c2 minus 2c1 is equal to minus 4c1. So bring it here. 4c2 minus 2c1 plus 4c1 is equal to 0. So we get 4c2 plus 2c1 equal to 0 implies c1 is equal to minus 1 by 2c2. Okay, keep it as it is. Let us use the second condition, that is x equal to 0. When x equal to 0, y is equal to 0. That is also one of the conditions. So when x equals to 0, what happens for y? Let us see. Consider the equation y, that is this particular equation. Let me name it equation 1. Putting x is 0 and y is 2. In this equation, we get e raised to 0, which is 1, c1 cos 2x is going to gonna be 1 plus c2 sin 2x will be 0 is equal to y, y is 2. Implies we get c1 is equal to 2. Substituting c1 is 2 here, we get 2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 c2. So c2 will get simplified and you are gonna get c2 value as minus 4. Therefore, the final solution for the from this first equation is what is c1, what is c2. You just plug in the values from whatever you got here. So we get y is equal to e power minus x into how much is c1? 2. So 2 cos 2x. And how much is c2? Minus 4. Minus 4 sin 2x. Then take out 2 common. 2 e power minus x cos 2x minus 2 sin 2x is the particular solution. What do you call this? This equation 1 is the general solution, and this equation, what we got, is said to be the particular solution of the given differential equation. Understood?